Good morning, YouTube. I'm just posting this video because time has flown by very fast. And I leave tomorrow to head towards Georgia. And I will begin my Appalachian Trail hike through on the 26th. Assuming all goes well, I'll be traveling on the Greyhound bus. I've heard it's a nightmare, so I've sent my pack ahead to the hostel. Hopefully I can count on UPS to get it there safely and on time. A few things I'd like to update that wasn't mentioned in previous videos is I made my own stick picks for the tracking pole to attach my camera to. This uses a standard little paper clip. Squeeze it open, and a 1/4-20 screw like you find on a quick release of the tripod. It works very nicely, it's very secure, it's easy on and easy off. No fiddling with the little rubber stoppers on the end of the tracking post. I was going to carry a leather wallet, and decided that was a little bit too heavy. So I looked around on Amazon and I was going to pick up one of these Tyvek type wallets. And I was just about to place the order when I decided I'd just attempt to make one myself. I had received a large Tyvek envelope in the mail that something came in. And it actually went pretty quick. This took a few minutes to make. I reinforced the outside edges with some black duct tape just as a precaution. I don't think that I had any problems with the Tyvek at all. It would probably last it, but just some little extra insurance there. The card has blink, so I've inserted a small piece, about dollar size, of aluminum foil as a deterrent. I don't think anybody who gathered any information, if they was walking by and grabbed it, could use it because of all the security features. But it's there, and if I should need it for something else, I can use it for that also. I only made two slots, one for ID, one for credit card. I'm pretty happy with it. It weighs in at 0.2 ounces. It took me about 10-15 minutes to make, and it seems reasonably sturdy. So that's that. I'm looking forward to my hike. Like I said, I'm going to do the Thru hike going northbound. Not sure how far I get because I have never really attempted anything like this before. As a child, I used to play out in the woods. It was grown up, lots of trees. Even had the old vines hanging from it, like Tarzan would swing from it. As a child, I would swing from these vines. Trees were about 4 feet, maybe apart, and I can swing from tree to tree. My uncle and I, when I was at my grandmother's, there's a lot of forestry there, hills, and we would scurry around through there and explore the place. Had a few springs, a little creek running through the property. Then when I was in parochial school, we went on an excursion to Gethsemane for the day as a field trip, and after mass with the monks and touring the place where they made cheeses, etc. We took a little hike up one of the knobs and back down. And, just little small frame occurrences when I was a child occurred. I mean, I only tented out once as a child. That was in the neighbor's yard. They put up a family-sized tent and put down a lot of blankets and things inside to make it comfortable, and we had a little bonfire. And somewhere along the line, I moved away from the outdoors to being pretty much an indoor person pretty consistently. And there's really not a whole lot to say. I'm a little anxious, a little bit excited. Tends to be nervous. But I think once I'm out there and become familiar with the environment and everything, that I'll have a pretty fun time. I want to thank every one of you who have commented, especially with your suggestions about cutting weight, suggesting different items that may be more useful than what I currently had, which also cut weight. I do appreciate it. I do hope that if you're able to, that you can contribute to one of the four charities, or all four charities, even if it's $5 a piece. I've given to them over the years, and I feel that they are the best charities, with the exception of the Epilepsy Foundation. It's pretty new. I just came across it not too long ago, walking by the television set. The news was on, and they were talking about it. And from what little research I've done on it, they seem to be a pretty good charity also, and do a lot of good, since about 50 million plus Americans, or, well, people, rather, worldwide, have some type or form of epilepsy. It's the third leading cause of any brain disorder. I'm going to attempt, as often as possible, to post videos as I hike the trail, and I will try anyway to keep them at least under 5 minutes. That way it won't be too boring for you to watch, and be a lot easier to upload in a shorter amount of time also. I still haven't completely decided whether to take the Canon digital SLR with me or not. I mean, I could shave off a few pounds there. I do want to have some nice photographs and memories of this time, because this may be the first and last. I may go ahead and opt to tag it along with me and see how the weight bears out. I am definitely going to take the camcorder I'm recording on now, and I have a nice little Kodak video still camera. It's ZE1, I believe is the model number on it. It's nice, compact, and small. And that'll be the one that I'll use to attach to my trekking pole. I have placed the email address in my descriptions. The Risky Business one. It's a Gmail account. Has ample storage. Everyone is welcome to email it. No spamming, please. I have separated from the at symbol just to prevent bots from gathering the email address and, you know, spamming it. Anyone that gets captured on my video, whether still images or video footage itself, and would like copies of it, they can just email that address and give their name and trail name, whatever, and we can communicate later on that. And if you happen to capture any images of me or video that you'd like to pass along to me, you can send it to that. Just put in the subject line Thru Hike 2014. Well, I'm going to wind this up. I still have some things to do before I depart tomorrow. I did order me a little pouch to put on my hip belt from Amazon. It's supposed to be here tomorrow, and hopefully I will receive it before I leave. I hope everybody that's attempting this hike, whether it's a section, day, Thru hike, either this year or next, that they have a pleasant adventure, they enjoy their excursion, and we have plethora sunshine days. Again, I want to thank everybody for watching. If you enjoyed the videos, I'd be happy to receive a thumbs up. If there's something you didn't like about the videos, you didn't like it for any reason, give it a thumbs down. One of the things I do ask, whether it's a thumbs up, thumbs down, is that you leave a comment to go with it. I'm no stranger to criticism, and as long as it's constructive, I have no issues with it. Everybody can learn something, improve on something. And maybe I'm speaking too slow in the video, maybe too fast, maybe I neglected to cover something you thought I should cover. I don't know. I don't read minds. I try to hit the highlights of what I think I would like to see in a video, what I have seen in videos, but I'm not judging them on a Hollywood standard. If you want to follow along, please do. You can track along with me. Just subscribe. That'd be easiest to help you follow along. Again, I want to recap that this is not just a track for myself, but I'd like to help the charities listed in the description below out as much as possible, sort of multitask this adventure, and a memorial for some family members who have passed away.